Hey guys, CSU back again with an informative series of Intro to InfoSec, that is Introduction to Information Security, which deals with cybersecurity, ethical hacking and penetration testing. In today's episode, we are taking a look at Starter Kit for Hackers, that is the basic requirements to be an hacker. This particular video deals with the basic prerequisites like basic hardware, software and knowledge you have to be familiar with. So let's get started. Well, on the top of the list we have hardware. All we need is a laptop or a PC which runs on Linux with a basic minimum specs of 8 gigs of RAM, a CPU with 4 cores, a 500 gigs of storage capacity. This storage capacity device can be either HDD or an SSD. I prefer mostly SSD for you. And Wi-Fi adapter which supports monitoring mode and packet injection. Basically, a laptop has pre-built and Wi-Fi card which doesn't support monitoring mode and packet injection. By purchasing an external Wi-Fi adapter, we can enable to do Wi-Fi hacking or an MATM attack. Why I said these are the minimum specs is we will do live exploitation on the virtual machines. These machines are have to be installed on our PC. For supporting those huge softwares like VMware or an VirtualBox, we need to get these minimum requirements. And that's it for basic hardware guys, and if we move on to software section, the first thing will be on Linux. Especially for hackers, it will be Kali Linux or Parrot Security OS as they're most recommended. Why only this means? By the way, I also are running on Kali Linux, just a sec, I'll show you. And yeah, this is the Kali Linux UI we'll be looking at. Actually, I modified this mate version of the Kali Linux and redesigned according to my comfort. It has tons of tools pre-built in it for hacking. It also have popular tools pre-built in it, and that's why most of the hackers prefer Kali over the any Linux distribution. And most of the softwares like Bubsuit, Nmap, Metasploit, Wireshark, and many more tools are pre-built on Kali, so we don't need to install heavy software packages or tools or third-party application in it. It has well categorized section for the information gathering, vulnerability analysis, web application analysis, database management, password attacks, wireless attacks, reverse engineering, exploitation tools. And the most important topic is exploitation tools. And my most favorite part is also this. It has Armitage and Beef XSS framework, which is cross-site scripting, which includes JavaScript for hacking and website. And Metasploit framework, which is used to create payloads and exploit any device. Metasploit framework, payload creator, subtitles, SQL map, terminator, etc, etc. And snipping and spoofing, post exploitation, forensics, reporting tools, social engineering tools, system services, etc, and much more. And if you want to be a hacker, you need to know about Linux. It is a required foundational skill. It's actually a prerequisite to do anything in hacking. You definitely have to know it. So that's why in upcoming series, I'm gonna teach you Linux and its tools. So stay tuned to us. If you like my channel, a sub would be great. And the second tool in the software section will be Tor Browser, definitely. It is used for surfing deep web and dark web and accessing dot onion sites. Just a sec, I'll show. If you see this, actually I'm running an dot onion domain on my Tor browser. So it is very useful for hackers to stay anonymous while browsing internet. And the next part will be a virtual box, which will be used to create any virtual machines. Virtual box, yeah, here. Yeah. It is used to create any virtual machines like Windows, Mac, yes, it supports Mac also, and Windows, Linux, and much more. Here you can see it supports Linux, Solaris, BSD, IBM OS, Mac OS, and other OS. For example, I'm selecting Microsoft Windows, and here it has all the versions of Microsoft Windows. So it is very useful for hackers to create an instance of virtual machines in it. And the next one will be Anonser. It is a tool developed for anonymity, just like nvpn. It tunnels the whole device through Tor network for our anonymity. Like, sudo anon serve start. Here you can see I'm connecting to Tor. Yeah, and now I'm under unsafe tunnel. This will be great to a hacker to be stay anonymous in the entire internet. And that's it for software section, guys. And if you move on to the basic knowledge, you have to know the basic CS knowledge for this. That is the fundamentals of computer, like operating computer and navigating through the system and much more, like connecting to internet and much more. You need to know the basics of the operating the system and be familiar with Python and C, guys, because most of the tools written will be in Python and the most exploits will be written in C language and Python. So you need to know, are familiar with these languages, not to an expert level, but you have to be familiar with this language. And the next one will be the Linux or its bash, and learn scripting skills like database management and SQL, and be familiar with cryptography, guys, because most of the contents are encrypted with some encryption. Thus only cryptography will help us, like passwords are stored in database with an encryption of MD5 hash. To decrypt it, you need to know the basic cryptography skills and learn to be stay anonymous. It is the basic nature of a hacker to hide their identity. Use Tor or proxy chain tools for it. And the final thing of this episode is experiment a lot. I repeat it again, experiment a lot and try harder nature. Cause if you blindly follow any other tools or exploit, you will definitely be a script kiddie forever. And the next video in this series will be on Linux for hackers. So stay tuned to us for more content. And so that's it for today, guys. Hope you all enjoyed and learned something new. Keep supporting me, like and subscribe for more content like this. Share to supporters.